another one. Yeah. I'll get you another trick. I don't care. I think it's more amazing when you know. I think it's more amazing when you know. At one time or another, you may have seen a magician take a piece of rope and cut it and put it back together again. I'm going to do the same thing, but I'm going to show you step by step how it's done. Before we start, I'd like to have someone from the audience thoroughly examine this piece of rope, make sure it is, in fact, what it appears to be, an ordinary, unprepared piece of rope. Would you go over every inch of that, okay? Thanks so much. I'm kidding. Look at it closer than that. Make sure there are no trap doors or mirrors, no hidden assistance. It doesn't stretch. It's just rope. Am I right? This guy looked like a professional.
Yes.
He knows his ropes. Seemed like a rope to you, sir?
It's a rope.
Obviously it is, otherwise I wouldn't have let him look at it. It's just a piece of rope like you'd find in any bedroom. Mm. The secret is not...
Different color.
What? Uh-oh. Oops. Too much information. Now, what you want to do is, at one time or another, you've probably seen a magician take a piece of rope, cut it, put it. I'm going to do the same now. I'll show you how it's done. First step, you want to measure this. The secret to this is a special knot called the Mongolian Pop Knot. It was invented by the famed horsemen of Mongolia. It's a kind of a slip knot. Sometimes those boys had to leave town in kind of a hurry. First step is to measure the rope carefully. You want to make sure that when you cut, you get two pieces of rope exactly the same length. To put these back together again, I know, measure twice, cut once. And anyway, first step is to measure the rope carefully. You want to make sure that when you cut, you get two pieces of rope the same length. Take one rope, twist around the other rope like this. Come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have one Mongolian pop knot. Now, some of you are laughing, but there's people here trying to learn. At this point, you simply reach in your pocket, you take some magic pixie dust. I call it pixie dust. I have no idea what they call it in Mongolia. You sprinkle the pixie dust on the knots like that. In a few seconds, the pixie dust will cause the knot to dissolve and pop right off the rope, leaving you where you are. Time seeing exactly how to tie that knot, especially those of you in the cheaper seats. We'll do it again. This time we'll cut the rope into three even pieces. That gives you twice as much chance to see how the knot is tied, since it takes two Mongolian pop knots in order to put three pieces of rope back together again. Am I going too fast?
No.
Because it very seldom happens. Now, folks, remember, when you try this at home, make sure you cut all three pieces of rope the same length. If you make a mistake here, the trick will not work. No, seriously, if you make a mistake here, the trick won't work. For example, if instead of cutting three ropes to all the same length, you were to make a mistake, get one a little short, the trick won't work. You get one about right and the other one too long, the trick won't work. All three ropes have to be the same length. And this could happen to anyone. So if it happens to you, there is a way out. As long as I'm teaching you the trick, I'll teach you what we magicians call a contingency plan. Make a mistake cutting the ropes, you fold them over one at a time like this, short and medium and long, and you say the magic word, sim salabim. Sim salabim. You have to say these with a certain amount of conviction. soon. Come on, this is the hard part of the trip. Sim. Salabim.
Wow.
Suddenly the ropes begin to stretch.
Wow.
And stretch, and stretch like that. Wow. Leaving you where you started from.
Wow.
Wow.
I know it kills me. Back to the Mongolian pop knot. We take rope number one, rope number two. I'm going to tie these together. Watch closely. I'll go slow. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You know, I fail to see the humor in this. I don't think I'm alone in that either. One, Mongolian. Second knot is tied the same way. You may want to take notes.
We got this.
You take one rope, twist around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through,
yay,
and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, pull tight. You have two Mongolian pop knots. Everybody with me so far?
Yes.
Good. At this point, you simply reach in your pocket. You take some magic.
Pixie dust.
That's very good. That's very studious. You sprinkle the pixie dust on the knots like this. Any questions so far?
No. Where do you get your pixie dust?
Yeah. What?
That's a trick.
Where do you get the pixie dust?
Yeah.
I grind my own. Not just for economy, but for purity. I would send the kids out of the house because pixies can make a hell of a noise. It can be distressing if you're very young. Any other stupid questions? The only way we're going to learn. In a few seconds, the pixie dust will cause the knots to dissolve and pop right off the rope, leaving you where you started from.